Yes, friends, welcome to the science class. In the last class, we started with our third topic, that is nothing but fabrics through fiber. And we studied about the clothings, about that nothing but the fabrics. We studied about the different types of cloth. We are going to collect the different type piece of the cloth from the tailoring shop. So that we should know that what type of material which is being made by using those clothing cloth are which is being made by the what type of materials, how does those materials are being made, from where does those materials, clothing materials are coming. So that clothing is nothing but it is the fabrics. If you remember the last class, clothing is nothing but it is the fabric. In the same manner, why we should go to the tailoring shop to check the variety of the clothing, for the purpose of the, we should know that from actually where does that clothing material is coming. So then we are going to do the first activity, that is nothing but we should go to the tailoring shop and collect the different types of the pieces of the cloth, and you have to label those cloths in the manner that from which material they are being made. For example, if it is made by the wools, we have to label it as wool. If it is being made by the cottons, we have to label it as cotton. If it is being made by the what? If it is being made by the silk, we have to name it as silk. In the same manner, if it is made by the synthetic fibers, then we have to name it as synthetic. If we doesn't know how to name, label those things, we can take the help of our parents, or we can take the help of the tailor, which is present in the tailoring shop. This is the first activity. We have to collect the pieces of the cloth which are present after, which are left over after the stitching of those cloths by the tailor. Now what we have to do in the second activity, the last class only we discussed those things. The second activity, we are going to take that piece of cloth, and for example, we are going to take the cotton cloth, the label cloth, piece of the cloth which is labeled with the cotton, we are going to take that cloth. We have to take that cloth, we have to check the loose threads which is present on the edges. Loose threads which are present on the edges, if you check this shirt, these are the loose threads which are present on the shirt. We have to remove those threads. We have to pull out those threads from that shirt, so that we should know that from what those things are made of. So that fabrics which are we are using, that is nothing but clothing, which are the loose threads, it is made by the closely arrangement of those loose threads. We can say that the fabrics which we are going to use are made by the closely arrangement of those threads. Those threads are nothing but, if you remember the last class, are known as yarns. If you remember last class, which is known as yarns. Yarns are nothing but these are the loose threads, or it is the pattern of the threads which are present on the clothing material, that is nothing but the fabrics. Fabrics are made by the close arrangement of the yarns. You say that we can know that fabrics are made by the close arrangement of the yarns. Up to that point we discuss. Next we have to do the further activity. Next we have to take that yarns, thread like structure, and we have to see that closely. What we have to do? We have to hold one edge of that thread in our hand, or by means of that thumb. Another hand we have to rotate it, or we have to apply the force on it by using the fingers or any can, anything. When you check those things, when you apply the force on the one hand, the edge of the thread by one thumb, and another edge, when we check those things, it again contains small thread-like structures. That is nothing but it again contains the strands. Tiny strands. Those strands together constitute what? They constitute thread. If we take the example, we have to put the thread in a needle. Right, when you take a needle, on the eye of the needle we are going to put the thread. When it starts to put that thread in the eye of the needle, is it possible it is easily going to enter into that needle? No, it is not possible. It is not going easily going to enter into that needle. So that what we have to do, we have to apply the saliva, and we have to rub that thread so that it easily enter into the what? Eye of the needle. When you closely check them, again it has the different strands. Some strands will be outward, some strands will be together. When you check that, those strands making the that thread to doesn't enter into the eye of the needle. For that reason, we are going to apply this enema and we are going to rub that end of that needle so that it directly enter into the eye of that needle. So that what are those strands, what are those tiny strands are present, which are present in the yams or which are present in the threads. Those yams or those tiny strands which are present on the thread or which are present on the yams are nothing but the fibers. They are nothing but the fibers. So that we can say that the threads are the what yams which are made by the close arrangement of thread like structures or thread like filaments. Those thread like filaments together constitute what? They are going to constitute yarn or thread. The arrangement of close arrangement of thread or yarn is going to constitute what? Fabrics. They are going to constitute what? Fabrics. By this we can say that fabrics are made by the fabrics. From where does they made? From which material they are made? By the close arrangement of the yarns. By the close arrangement of the yarns. They are made by the yarns. When you closely look at yarns, yarns are nothing but the threads. When you closely look those things, they are the small structural filaments or small structural strands. Those strands are nothing but the fibers. Those strands are nothing but the fibers. So then we can say that yarns are made of the fibers. Fabrics are made from the yarns. So their fabrics are directly made from the which material? They are made from the fibers only. They are made from the fibers only. So that the chapter name itself says that fabrics to fiber. Actually, fiber is going to converted into fabric. But how are the fabrics are made from the fibers? We are going to fabrics to the fiber. That is nothing but fabrics are made from the yarns. How yarns are made? Yarns are made from the fibers. What are the fibers? Fibers are the nothing but fibers is a fine thread like filament which is present. Fiber is a fine thread like filament which is present in the threads or yarns. Those yarns together constitute what? They are going to constitute of fibrics. By together we can say that fibers are nothing but the smallest unit which is present in the fabric. The smallest unit which is present in our fabric or clothing is nothing but the fibers. So that I hope this is clear. From fibers to the threads or yarns, from yarns to threads to the fabrics. In this way, fabrics are made by using the fibers. Now, actually, from where does the fibers we are going to get? We know that fibers are going to constitute what? Threads, they are going to constitute what? They are going to constitute fabrics by the clothing materials being made by the fibers. From where does the fibers are we are going to get? From actually which source we are going to get the fibers? And what are the different types of the fibers? So that depending on the material which we are going, depending on the source from where we are going to get that fibers, we have the main two types of the fibers. The material or the source from where we are going to get that fibers. And depending on those things, we have two types of fiber. First type is nothing but it is synthetic fibers. First type is a natural fiber. Second type is the synthetic fiber. Natural fiber is nothing but which is naturally occurring, which is naturally available for the purpose of the making of the fabric. Right, natural fiber is nothing but it is naturally available. Now for example, take the example of the sunlight. Sun is a natural source or not? It is a natural source. That means sunlight is naturally available. The light which we can see by using that we can see the objects is nothing but it is the natural. The source of the light is nothing but what? It is the sun. Therefore, sun is a natural source for the sunlight. And what do you mean by bulb? Directly we can get the light from the bulb? No. It is the man-made. Being invention of the man, it is the man-made bulb. It is not a natural source. Natural source should be available from the start of the earth. it should be available from the startup there, and it is naturally occurring. The source of those things is naturally occurring. In the same manner for the oxygen, the source is plants. They are naturally giving the oxygen to us. That is also natural source. From where does the water is going to come? It is being made by the man? No, it is naturally occurring. So that water is also a natural source. So that in this manner, natural fibers are nothing but which are naturally available. The sources of those fibers are naturally available. So then we can say that natural fibers are which are those which are naturally available. The fibers which are obtained from the plants and animals. Plants and animals are naturally occurring, right? Plants and animals which are is being made by human beings? No. Is it man-made? No. Those are naturally obtained. Those are naturally present on the earth. From those things, we are going to get the fibers. We are going to get the fibers which are filaments for making of the fabrics. If those are naturally occurring, then we can say that those are the natural fibers. So they are the fibers which are going to obtain from the plants and animals is nothing but the natural fibers. For example, cotton. We are going to get the cotton from the cotton plant. Cotton plant is nothing but it is also naturally occurring. In the same manner, we are going to take the fiber from the jute. Fiber from the jute. Jute is naturally, it is naturally present on the earth surface. That means if you are going to take the fiber from the jute, which is naturally occurring, then it is known as natural fiber. In the same manner, silk. Silk is being animal being. Is it man-made or it is naturally there in the naturally there in the nature? It is naturally there in the nature. So that silk is also what? It is also a natural fiber. The silk from this, the silk which we are going to get from the silk worms is naturally nothing but it is a natural fiber. In the same manner, wool. The wool which is coming from the wool which is coming from the sheep or goat, it is also the natural fiber. It is naturally growing on the sheep and the hairs of that sheep and goats are naturally growing. It is not man-made, so that it is known as a natural fiber. So that remember, natural fiber is nothing but nature. It is not a man-made one. It naturally present in the nature. In the same manner, synthetic fiber. What do you mean by synthetic fiber? Right. Up to some extent, the clothing material which are produced by the natural fibers were left to some extent up to the 19th century. After the 19th century, the demand for the clothing material increases. The clothing material demand increases so that production of the clothing material should be increased. So that if you follow the natural fibers only, it is not possible that we are going to produce a high amount of clothing by using the natural resources only. For that reason, women invented the synthetic cloths. Human being invented the different type of material from which we are going to produce the fabric. Those fibers are nothing but those are the synthetic fiber. The man-made fibers are nothing but those are the synthetic fibers. So that we can define synthetic fiber as synthetic fiber are made from the chemical substances. Synthetic fiber which are nothing but those are made from the chemical substances. Right? And synthetic fibers are man-made fibers. The synthetic fiber are going to be made by the man using the chemicals. By using the chemicals we are going to produce the synthetic fibers. About this we are going to study in the 8th class. About these things we are going to about the synthetic fibers. There is a chapter on that synthetic fibers in the 8th class. So that at that class we are going to study those things. Up to that point, just remember synthetic fibers are made from the chemical substances and those are the man-made clothing material. So that for example, those things is examples rayon, nylon and polyester. Rayon, nylon and polyester are the materials which are used as the synthetic fiber for the purpose of the fabrics. So that this fiber or synthetic fiber is also known as artificial fiber. It is also known as artificial fiber. Artificial fiber, man-made fiber and synthetic fiber all are same. This fiber is nothing but it is artificial fiber. These are things about the fibers. What is the fiber? Fiber is nothing but filament like thread like filament or the strands of that which are present in the threads, or yarns. What are the yarns? Yarns are nothing but which are threads which are present in the cloth, piece of the cloth. What are the fabrics? Fabrics are nothing but the cloths. From where does the fabrics are made? Fabrics are made from the yarns. Yarns to yarn. From where does the yarns are made? From the fibers only. So then, what are the different types of the fibers? One is natural fiber. Second one is synthetic fiber. I hope this much is clear about the fiber. Fiber. Next, we are going to discuss about in this class. In this topic, we are just only going to discuss about the fibers from the plant source. We are going to discuss about the fibers from the plant source and how does those fibers are being made by using the plant source. Being made by the plant source. So that there are 4 to 5 plant sources are there. In this class, in this topic, we are just going to discuss about the cotton fiber as well as we are going to discuss about the jute fiber one by one. Now we are going to discuss about the fibers from the plant source. Now first fiber is nothing but cotton. You came across cotton, cotton cloth. Now for example, one of the very budgeted t-shirt type of cotton candy or cotton candy, that is nothing but it is the one of the easily available low rate cost available t-shirt. Those are made from the cotton or those are made from the cotton fiber. So then we have to discuss from where does, from how the cotton fibers are being made. In the same manner, we are going to discuss about the jute also. So then there are different processes are going to take place for the purpose of those cotton fibers to be being made. So that one by one, each by each process we are going to see it, and each process we are going to see and each process we are going to discuss in the elaborated form. So first of all, we are going to discuss about the what is cotton, from where does the cotton is going to come. Cottons come from the cotton plant. Cottons come from the where? Cottons come from the cotton plant. If you remember, the fields in the southern side where the black soil is present, there is the production, there is going to harvest the plants of the cotton. In those plants we are going to take out the cotton. So that cotton comes from the cotton plant. Right, both plant and the fiber. Both the plant and the fiber are called together called as the cotton. The fiber of that cotton cloth as well as the plant of that cotton is nothing but the cotton. Directly we can say that cotton. If you take the example of t-shirt, you can't say that cotton fiber. This is made by the cotton fiber. This is the cotton cloth. The clothing is nothing but we can label it as cotton cloth. And which is grown in the black soil and a warm climate. But where does those things are developed? Where does the cotton plants should be developed or grown? Cotton plants are developed or grown in the black soil. Black soil region, for example, the black soil which is present in this region, and the climate is also warm, so that we can grow the cotton plants. From this, we are going to take out the cotton from the where does it is developed? It is developed, it is grown in the black soil and warm climate. From where the cotton is going to be taken. Now, processing of the cotton fiber. We came to know that cotton is grown here. We are going to take out the cotton. And how does that cotton is going to be being processed? So that we are going to get the cotton fiber. We have to process that cotton to get the cotton fiber. And another thing in this case, we have to name the states where the cotton is being grown highly. The maximum amount of cotton is grown highly, or maximum amount of cotton which is grown in which state, you have to list those states, at least 3 to 4 states from top to bottom. First state, second state, third state, fourth state. You have to name those states where the cotton is being grown. Now, processing of the cotton fiber. Now, processing of the cotton fiber requires n number of stages, n number of processes. There are only 5 processes which are going to be take place for the cotton is being to convert into cotton fiber. Those steps are nothing but first step is nothing but is binning, second is carding, third step is drawing, fourth step is spinning, fifth step is weaving. So then, what is the first step? When beginning, Ginning is nothing but the removal of the seeds from the fiber. It is the removal of the seeds from the fiber. Second step, carding is nothing but it is the cleaning and separating of the fibers stick together. It is the step for the cleaning and separating the fibers stuck together. Which are stuck together, you have to separate those things. Third step is nothing but drawing. Drawing is nothing but stretching of the fiber. You have to stretch that fiber. First, removal of the seeds from the cotton. Second, cleaning and separating of the warts. Cleaning and separating of the fibers. Next thing, stretching of the fiber. You have to stretch that fiber so that it becomes a thread-like structure. And the fourth one is spinning. Drawing yarn thread from the fiber. You have to draw a yarn thread from the fiber. You have to take those fibers. You have to closely spin those things and become this yarn, like thread. You have to make a thread. Lastly, weaving. You have to make a fabric from the yarn. You have to use those fabrics or you have to use those threads and you have to arrange those closely so that we are going to produce the fabric from the yarn. These are the steps we are going to follow for the production of the cotton fiber, processing of the cotton fiber so that we are going to produce the cotton fabrics using this step. Those steps are ginning, carding, drawing, spinning and weaving. So that we are going to discuss one by one steps. Now first step is nothing but weaving, sorry ginning. First step is nothing but it is the ginning. What is the purpose of the ginning? Ginning is nothing but in the ginning we have to remove the seeds which are present in the cotton. Which are present in the cotton fibers. We have to remove those seeds so that we are going to get the correct cotton. We have to get the correct cotton, by those cottons we are going to produce the cotton fabric. So that one by one we are going to see those things. The first step is ginning. If you see the plants of the cotton, which are grown in the black soil in the warm climate, when you see those things, it is going to become mature, it is going to be grown. When they grow, they are going to produce the flowers. By those flowers, they are going to produce the fruits. The fruits will be like ball-like structures. Right? The fruits will be like ball-like structures. Which are the present on the plants. If you take the plant of the cotton, there will be flowers which is our the fruit which is going to produce like this ball-like structure. Right. After the maturity comes, after they are fully grown, the maturity comes, the ball, the fruit which are present ball-like structure, they are going to open up. When they open up, they are going to produce the cottons. So that the fruits of these balls are nothing but those are known as cotton balls. These fruits of the cotton plant is nothing but the cotton balls. When they mature, that is nothing but they become and they fully grown. When the fruit becomes mature, it is going to open up. If it is there, the cotton will be cotton fiber will be present inside this fruit. After they become mature, they are going to open up. The cotton which is the cotton fiber which is present inside this fruit is going to come out. If it is going to come out, from there we are going to extract that cotton. In that cotton we have the seeds of those cotton things. Cotton fiber. Those seeds should be removed. How they are going to be removed by the processing, by the hands. We are going to remove those seeds by our hands. Separated from the seeds continuously, we are going to separate those seeds continuously. After the separation of those seeds, the ginning process is completed. Nowadays, for the purpose of the ginning, we are using the machinery. We are using the equipment so that the amount of the time consumption should be considerably took less. So that we are going to use the equipment for the purpose of the ginning. I hope ginning process is clear. That is nothing but the plants of the cotton becomes having the fruits. Those fruits are nothing but the cotton balls. cotton bolls, when they become to the mature stage, they are going to open up. When they open up, they contain the cotton. That cotton can be separated from the seeds by using the procedure of the kinning. They are going to remove it. We have to remove the seeds separately. We have to separate the seeds. By separating seeds, thus when we separate the seeds from the cotton, the process is completed. We have the separate cotton, we have the separate seeds. What we require is not only the cotton. In this manner, we are going to separate those things. So that kinning is nothing but it is the procedure for the removal of the seed from the fibers. That is nothing but the cotton from the, we can say that cotton from the, one by one I am going to write a cotton from the cotton which is present. Cotton which is present. Which is present in the fruit. In the fruit, that is nothing but cotton ball. Cotton ball. Which will be present in the cotton ball. After the maturation, when that cotton ball becomes mature, when that tree becomes fully grown, after the maturation, the cotton ball is going to open up. It is going to open up and the cotton is going to come out. This is going to open out, the cotton is going to come out. That cotton is collected. That cotton is collected and the seeds are separated by using man force, man labor, or by using the equipment. This is the procedure for the kinning. Now we have obtained the separated of cotton fiber. Now that cotton fiber can be further followed by this step. We are going to further process it so that we are going to get the cotton fabric. Those things we are going to discuss in the next class. Up to that point, just revise those things. Just go through the various